Hello, welcome back. In the last lecture, we understand conceptually how virtual user generator is listening to the traffic between the client and server and records it to a reusable script that we can use to load test. And in this video, we are going to give our first attempt to do the recording. Alright? And if you are following my lectures in a sequential order, then you must be realizing that we have installed module application on an Apache LAMP stack on the local machine. And right now, I have set up everything so that I can access this URL. Then I'm going to do login, and then I will enter my user ID and password, and I submit the form. Then I'm going to browse a course and I log out. So these are the five-step process, and sometimes they call it business process. My goal here in this video is to record these things and to show you that virtual user generator can record it. Alright, so the first thing what I'm going to do, I'm going to start my virtual user generator, and then I'll click on this create. Okay, and this is going to give me a new script dialog box, and the first thing that will ask me to choose the protocol. Since this is a web application, therefore I'll choose web HTTP HTML as my protocol. Then ask you to give me a name. I give the script name to be demo. And I will give a location where the script is going to be stored permanently. Then I can give a solution name. This is an optional. The solution name is essentially coupling multiple related script together, so that whenever, instead of opening a script one by one, if we open the solution, then all the scripts going to loaded to the virtual user generator editor. Alright, and for the simplicity, I just keep ignoring this, and let's say create. And as you see, it's created a script called demo, and then couple of things. We'll explain all those action extra files and runtime settings in later videos, and we'll, in this video, our goal is to record the activities. So to record the activities, you click on this record button here, and it will give you a recording dialog box. In the recording dialog box, it will ask you, the first thing is that on which action. So these are the actions like init, action, and end. And there's a reason why they give you three actions, and also you can create more actions if you want. Alright. So let's choose by default, record all those actions that we are going to do into this action block. And then it will ask you what kind of on where you want to record. Do you want to record on a web browser or a Windows application? So for me, I'll choose a web browser, and then it will, what kind of web browser you want to choose. Let's choose Google Chrome. Then it will ask you the URL address to go, but don't give, you know, we can do it later, so not a problem. And then it will ask you, are you going to start recording immediately the browser opens, or you want to start in delayed mode? You can do, if you do immediately, what is going to happen is that it is going to, like, say for example, I'm going to start my browser. When I start my browser, is going to, you know, basically it's going to before I actually do any of my activities, it has already been, you know, sent. So the browser has already sent some request to different servers. Okay, so that is the reason that, you know, you might do in delayed mode. Or say for example, you are recording something, you have a script where you have already recorded two steps, step one and step two, and you want to start with step three. So in that case, a delayed mode recording is the way to go. And you can open the browser, you can browse to these two links, but VueGen is not going to record anything until you explicitly say at the step three that you start recording now. So I just put it immediately, and also it's given working directory. Like now, if you have any configuration files and so on, so that is going to start from here. So by default it is load on or bin, but generally it's not a good idea to give load on or bin. Instead of, you just give C work temp or something like that. And there are some advanced options are there. We are going to discuss later. Okay. And now click on start recording. What is doing right now? It opened the browser, and it's already record 27 events. Okay, so this floating toolbar, what we are seeing is keeping track of what is the happening between the browser and outside. and which are already recorded 27 events. Notice that we have not yet started our application to record. But these 27 events, we can later on, we can ignore those things. That is where, like, if you do not want to record these 27 events, you can always start in the delayed mode. Okay, and let's do our first step. So we have to go to this localhost module. So click on that. See, look like the counts has already increased. So now we recorded 134 events just by doing one step. Okay, so let's put it here and then click on login. Okay, so there's some more events being recorded, and now give the username. And say login, and then click on this course called test course. Okay, so that's all. So by this, like, if you see, we have recorded these 5 steps, and virtual user generator has already kept track of 253 events. And then you stop recording. So now the code being generated. Okay, so just close this design studio right now. So essentially what you see, all these steps before that are all those things we don't really need it, because this is just, you know, the moment you start Google is just doing something to google.com. actually, my recording really starts from here when I enter localhost/module. So therefore, what I'm going to do, I'm going to remove all these things. All right, and now this is what is my script. Okay, so if you see this, you know, this looks like a C code. Okay, and this is a function called web_URL, and these are the parameters. And then if you see, like, you know, in our activity to record, we have given 5 activities. Okay, so we have given 5 activities, and if you see the script, this is the function number 1, this is function number 2, function number 3, function number 4, and function number 5. So what essentially the VueGen did, it, like, you know, whenever you are recording, it listens to you and is learned, and it instead of those activities, it put some C API, it put some C functions. Okay, so that this C function will do the same thing. For example, you are going to the browser and giving this URL, and this web URL code, when it's going to run, is going to run exactly the same thing. It's going to send a request and get the localhost/module page. Okay, then in this, then you are clicking on that link, that login link, and this function is going to do exactly the same thing. Then this web submit form, whatever you are entering there, username is teacher1 and password is welcome1, it keeps tracks of all those things, and this function is going to essentially submit that form. Then this API is going to browse to the course called test course, and this API is going to log out from the system. Okay, so see, like how the VueGen helps you in creating a script, so that if you run this script multiple times, then you will do multiple times login, browse the course, and then log out. Okay, and if you run with this thing 100 times to get in simultaneously, you basically simulated 100 users. Okay, so this is the basic concept of VueGen recording, right? And then whatever default things that is going to give, it may not work all the time. So that is where we're going to learn in the next chapter how to customize this script. Since this script is C based, then you need to know a little bit of C so that you can modify this script. So for example, if I put a for loop here and iterated 10 times, then this is going to run 10 times. But the key thing here is that look how virtual user generator abstractize your activities to a human readable script. Right,